Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to the episode of Nekojishi. When we last left off, we had met all these wonderful animal peoples, and now we're at the decision of who will sleep with us tonight. So, based on all of your guys' comments, it looks like the majority winner is Papa Guardian Tiger, so let's go with that. The tiger has been sleeping with me this whole time. It's only right for him to take the place next to me.
Aw, this is too cruel, Lio.
Sorry, Senpai. I'll get you a quilt. It's the least I can do to make up for it.
Aw, boo-hoo.
I go to the closet and get out the spare sheets and pass them to Senpai.
Alright, if this is the case...
Senpai rolls out the sheets quickly.
This is my territory now. No one else can trespass.
This room is in no way big enough for someone to claim part of it. That territory is right next to the door, so you can't even get out without stepping on his sheets. Senpai, how can I get out of the room with you blocking the way?
Of course Lio gets a free pass. I welcome you into my territory, and even to sleep with me on the floor.
There is absolutely no space for me to squeeze into his territory. It's alright, Senpai. I know you're really excited, but I'm really tired at the moment. Can you just allow me to sleep for a while?
Well, it's not like I'm the one forcing you to stay awake.
Letting out a sigh, I go to the door and turn off the light. After turning off the light, I lay myself into the bed and get cozy under the quilt. The tiger is sitting on the bed as well. It's a bit small in my bed for two, and he's not exactly small with his muscular body taking up most of it. Is he really going to be sleeping with me every night? I don't think I could fall asleep that easily with a huge figure next to me. Hey, are we going to sleep like this?
Yes. Though, since you can see me, you can also feel me now. It does make it a bit cozy.
The tiger glances at the bed, then lies down on his side and proceeds to spread his arms across the pillow and pats the mattress.
Just sleep on it. It's okay. I won't let you fall off the bed.
He raises his other arm, apparently going to hold me in his arms. Although he is trying to stop me from falling off, it also means I'll be sleeping in his embrace. I don't think I have any other options, though. Leopard cat? Is this Senpai? Okay.
Lio, it would be a waste if we don't eat this stew. Mind if I finish it?
Okay. I turn my head back and see Senpai eating from the paper bowl while sitting on the sheets. How can he eat in such a dark room? Hey, watch what you're doing. If you make a mess, I won't clean up after you.
Don't worry, I'll be really careful.
He answers while stuffing his mouth full of food. It's not my problem if he makes a mess, he's the one sleeping in it. I look back to the bed. The tiger's tucked in, taking a deep breath. I lie into the tiger's arms slowly. He pulls the quilt over me. It's a cool night, and the blanket is still a bit cool. But with his warmth there, I don't really feel it. I wrap myself tight in the blankets, keeping the warmth in. Usually it takes time to warm up the sheets, yet with the tiger here, it's already getting warm. Still, I can't fall asleep.
How many times are you going to talk about how cold it is? Just go to bed.
I'm covered in his arms, feeling the heat from his body. It's hard to keep calm like this. Doesn't he care at all that he's a god, sleeping with his worshiper like this? And he seems so calm. Ugh, why do I need to be so nervous? I try to control my breathing as I tighten up. There's no way this is real. At this point, I must be in some cheesy rom-com anime. Keep calm, Lio. Get rid of your lewd fantasies. This guy is a guardian tiger. A god. He's a god. I'm just thinking about this too much. Maybe he just wants to take care of me. Any other thoughts would be disrespectful. Trying to convince myself of this, I close my eyes. His body is so warm. How does this even work? If I couldn't feel him, I would ask. Does he really exist? I mean, how can I be sure? I'm the only person who can see him or touch him. What if I pluck out some fur? No, that would be incredibly disrespectful. But still, this is pretty incredible. Even though I come from a Jitong family, I never thought about actually meeting a real god. I only took the statue with me because Dad insisted.
How could I know there was a real god in it? And right here, this god, a giant tiger man, lies before me. Well, hugging me, really. If I couldn't see it myself, I wouldn't believe someone even if they told me. Besides, compared to the guardian tiger sleeping on my bed, that statue's nothing. Why'd he appear to me as an anthro tiger? Maybe his appearance is determined by my imagination? So perhaps it's totally based on my preference. He could just be a normal tiger to other worshippers. Actually, that's pretty cool. However, it's still a weird coincidence to have three anthro deities appear in a furry's home. I look around my room. Senpai is sleeping quietly on the floor, and the leopard is laying across the desk, right on top of my keyboard. How can he sleep like that? Hopefully he doesn't somehow turn it on and start pressing keys. Can spirits use keyboards anyway? I hope they sleep well. I can hear the tiger's smooth breathing. As it stands, I still can't fall asleep. Some say it's easy to go to sleep when exhausted, but everything that's happened is keeping me awake. Suddenly, the guardian tiger moves his arm to cover my entire chest, making my whole body tense up. I start to wonder how to escape from his embrace, just as the tiger gently touches my nose. You still awake?
Yes. Actually, gods like me do not really need sleep.
Then why have you all been fighting over my bed?
I'd imagine the kitten wants it because of his physical body. I have no idea about that aberrine devil. As for myself, well, I've gotten used to this. After all, there's nothing I can do while you're sleeping. Is it surprising that a god can get bored?
So you sleep with me all the time? I would have never noticed.
Well, you weren't able to touch me then. However, you're just like a childhood sweetheart to me. So, as such, it's quite normal for me to hold you and sleep with you.
Oh, so I'm your childhood sweetheart now.
Whatever you think, you are my worshipper, so it's my responsibility to protect you, just as if you were my child. You've grown up next to me for years. I'm not that old, after all. However you may call it, my playmate or childhood sweetheart.
Not old at all, huh?
Correct. I am just a fendling, you know. Precisely speaking, I was born after you brought me to Taipei, though I have no memories from my primal spirit.
That's not how childhood sweethearts work then, if you were only born so recently.
But I do remember everything about your childhood. Like, the last time you wet your bed was when you were...
Ah, stop.
Okay then. Simply put, I know everything about you and your family. So, do you think I'm qualified to be your childhood sweetheart?
Well, maybe. And why do you like that term so much?
There's no more appropriate word to be found.
You've definitely misunderstood it. Where in the world did you learn these words? Like, you know that childhood sweethearts typically get married to each other in stories, right?
Really? I had no idea about the implications. However, if our relationship is that good, it means I'll easily beat those two, or at least the kitten.
Ew, what is he talking about?
Lio, don't be distracted by those two, understood? After all, you're a son of the Lin family.
I didn't reply. I know where he comes from, and I know if I don't get a job after I graduate, I'll have to go home. But I don't want to think about that right now.
Lio, don't you want to go home?
I never thought he'd ask me straight out like this. I don't know. Honestly, I think back home is boring. Will you be angry at me?
I won't be angry at that. However, I still want you to consider going back. It's not that boring. At least it won't be now that you can see us. You could spend your whole life talking with all the other guardian tigers were there, even.
Yeah? I never thought about it like that before. Living with a lot of furry guardian tigers sounds pretty good? But...
It's alright. Take your time. There's no reason to decide right away.
I'll consider it seriously.
I know you're a good boy. Don't worry, we'll take very good care of you once you get home. As you must know, there are three guardian tigers protecting your family, but really, there are more than three of them.
What is this I? Glossary. Kaido. In the Mazu culture, Kaido, lit, clear the path, is a rite in the holy pilgrimage. During the Kaido rite, guardian tigers led the way and expelled devils en route for all of the gods in the pilgrimage. The holy pilgrimage is a ceremony where worshippers bring large god statues on a grand tour. People believe that gods can inspect their domain and see their people during the tour. Okay. Very interesting, there's a glossary for that.
Those three are well known because they usually show up in Kaido rites. We've got a bunch of brothers since each statue can hold its own particular spirit. There are many gods in the temple, though you may only be able to see the guardian tigers. But you'll definitely be shocked by their magnificence.
His stories rambled on. I'm enjoying them, but I was quickly growing tired. The last thing I could remember was being tightly hugged by the guardian tiger. Immersed in his low, warm voice, I fell asleep. Ugh, heavy. It's so heavy. Something is definitely pinning me down, suffocating me with its entire mass. I try to struggle against it uselessly. I can't even lift my arms or move my feet. I don't bother trying to turn myself over. A cool breeze hits my face, but it doesn't help with the heat. What's going on? I take a deep breath and open my eyes. There's a large shadow in front of my face. I blink hard and figure out that it's a wall of muscle covered with soft, fluffy orange fur. It looks nice. I mean, if it's not trying to kill me. I can't really enjoy the view while being suffocated. I muster the strength to move my head and tap on my guardian tiger's arm.
Lio?
Get up.
Sorry.
Finally, he spares my life by getting off my bed. I thought I was going to die. Getting crushed to death by my own guardian tiger is a pretty stupid way to do so.
You all right?
Not at all.
I'm so sorry. I forgot you can actually feel me now, so I just laid down like usual.
So he's been sleeping on me this entire time? Even if I couldn't feel him before, it's kind of a miracle that I'm not dead already.
All right, come on.
I cough while trying to control my breathing. Then the guardian tiger pulls me into his chest and pats me on the back. I feel like such a kid, the way he strokes the back of my neck with his fluffy hand. I take a deep breath. It's an exotic smell that melts into the atmosphere around his body. What's going on? So this is the smell of my guardian tiger? It's so incredible to think that he's standing in front of me when I know he doesn't physically exist. But right here is a strong chest to lean against, while his fur warms me in the crisp spring morning. It's almost enough to forget the way he almost crushed me last night. Alright, I'm fine. It's okay. I gently push him away.
Aw, what's going on, Lio?
Senpai sits up in his bed, looking sleepily. It seems like we just woke him up.
What are you guys doing? You're so lovey-dovey. Hell, what time is it?
Senpai looks for his mobile, and I pick up mine. It's 10 o'clock. Wow, I can't believe I woke up this late. I must have been exhausted last night. Morning, Senpai. It's 10 o'clock.
10? That's early. Let me get back to bed.
What? I know a lot of people skip morning classes on Monday, but you can't say that 10 o'clock is early. Sleep until whenever you want. I'm gonna get up. The tiger moves out of the way to let me off the bed. Then I suddenly notice a leopard standing in front of my desk. When did he wake up? Why would he be staring at me like that? Morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Lio.
I just had to slap the tiger in the belly to get him to reply. It was pretty rude, but damn, his rock-solid abs hurt my hand.
What? His rock-solid abs coated in fur.
Five more pieces.
What the hell is he dreaming about? 10. I have nothing to do before my afternoon class. School is nearby, so I can set off half an hour before class begins. So what should I do now? Usually I would just surf the internet, but now... Speaking of that, I guess Senpai still needs something to eat.
I'm pretty hungry right now, but I should probably wait until Senpai wakes up by himself. I turn on my desktop as usual, get ready to load some social media, but then I get a strange feeling. The tiger and leopard are standing right behind me, peeking at my screen God, I sometimes get all fucked up in pronouncing words. Furtively. There we go. God, what is wrong with my brain? I guess I'm still tired. Excuse me, what are you two doing?
What? This is what I usually do.
Watching everything I do on the computer?
Correct.
Could you stop, please? It's making me uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable? How so?
I mean, it's strange to be watched all the time.
Strange, but I do watch you all the time. Like I said, I know all the files on your computer.
Even then, it's a bit different when I actually know you're doing it. Not that it means I don't mind from before. Do they know my right to privacy? Granted, it's pretty strange to discuss rights of privacy with gods. But how can I relax while being watched? Sorry, but could you two just move away while I'm using my computer?
Fine. I just want to keep an eye on you. I'm not the only one living with you now. So you don't want others to know what you're doing, or just don't feel right while being watched?
Well, both.
Alright. I'll go get myself a book then.
The tiger goes and picks a book from my shelf, but even after taking it, the book itself is still on the shelf. How did he do that? Never mind, it's not important to me. Meanwhile, the leopard just went away on his own volition. Well, I'm finally free now. I can open some pages since they're still in the room, but it's way better now. With nothing else to do, I spend my time on the internet until 12. Senpai, it's time to get up.
Lyle? Morning. What time is it?
It's 12 already. Do you always have to get up this late?
It's pretty normal for me. Hard to change.
Oh, so that's how you waste your life away.
You'll understand more later in college.
He doesn't really care, does he? People say the longer you're in college, the less effort you put into it. I thought it was just an exaggeration. Anyway, Senpai, get up and have lunch. Otherwise, we're gonna miss class.
Yeah, alright. Let me wash my face first.
Senpai meanders out of the bed and goes to the bathroom. So, Senpai, what's your plans for this afternoon?
This afternoon? I'll just go to school with you.
Senpai is barely audible over the running water. So, when do you finish your classes?
Classes? I don't have any today.
Then why are you coming to school with me?
So I could stay with you, obviously.
What?
Come on, when a couple moves in together, the least they should do is go to school together.
Stop kidding me, Senpai. This isn't some cheesy romance manga, you know. Senpai walks out from the bathroom, wiping his face dry with my towel. Yes, my towel.
Well, take it easy. Anyway, I can't keep myself in your room all day long, and I don't have a key, so why don't we just go to school together?
He has a good point, but then why can't Senpai just go home? Senpai, I think it's better for you to go home. Moreover, you don't have any change of clothes with you, right?
Right, so I plan to grab whatever I need and bring it over here tonight.
Senpai, why are you insisting so hard on this?
Like I said yesterday, I can't lose to those two, so here's the deal.
Whatever, be my guest. So what about lunch?
Of course, I'd love to dine with you, Lyo.
I was just thinking about getting a sandwich.
What? Come on, Lyo, don't get a sandwich. There's no romantic atmosphere to that at all.
Why is that all you care about? I let out a deep sigh. So I'll just grab something to eat before class. If you want a proper lunch, just go and get it now. I'll wait and keep the door for you.
Ugh, I'd rather skip lunch if you don't eat with me.
Come on, unlike those two, you have a real body. You need to eat something.
I'll just grab something as well then. I'm not too hungry since I just woke up.
Okay, you're free to do whatever you want.
I'm totally fine.
Senpai sits back on the mattress, pulls up the quilts to cover his legs, and starts to focus on his phone. Alright, now that's sorted. I walk over and get back on my desktop and browse online until it's time for class.
Hey, Lyo, we should leave now.
Alright, right away. What? I close up my computer, then pick up my backpack, phone, and keys. It's time for me to go. I'm counting on you to look after the house while I'm gone, Guardian Tiger.
Wait, Lio. I'll go with you.
What? You mean you want to come to school with me? For what reason?
To protect you.
Come on, it's school. I don't need any protection. Also, apparently Naruto soundtrack just kicked on.
Nope. I'll be worried if you go alone. There's no way I trust that kitten, and the Aberrine will definitely follow you as well.
What's with you calling me a kitten?
Wait, are you going to school with me, Mr. Leopard?
Huh.
The leopard silently nods in response. So, all of you guys are coming to school with me. I look three cats up and down. They all turn to look at each other. Then they nod together. Why?
I'm not going to let down the opportunity to go to school with you.
Need to follow you. I have no reason to let these suspicious guys get close to you, so I'm definitely coming.
Putting your reason aside, Guardian Tiger, didn't you say that you can't be too far from the statue?
I'll be okay as long as I stick around a close worshiper. It'd be shameful if I couldn't even protect my Jitong.
God, what kind of situation am I even in?
No idea. Maybe it's karma.
What the hell? So I guess my karma's pretty crap then. If I can't even get some peace and quiet at school. Really, it's not bad to be around three beastmen, but where's my freedom? Where's my right to privacy?
Lio, you'll just need to get used to it. I've always gone with you. You just couldn't see me. Pretend I'm not there, perhaps?
It's not that simple. And how do you expect me to deal with these two?
You don't see me.
I just want to go to class with Lio. I have a right to go as an actual college student, you know.
That's not the point, Senpai.
I can walk with you to school. Then we can talk together. I can even do your class notes. I'll do whatever you want, Lio.
I can't deny his enthusiasm. How cunning of you.
So I take it that it's a yes? Give in to me your inner desires.
What? All right. You can come if you want. I have nothing else better to do anyway. Just no funny stuff, okay? I get my things and open the door, letting the others out before locking it behind them. On our way, I go with Senpai and get some sandwiches and soy milk for lunch. Then we head off to class. Like he wanted, Senpai is with me in my class. Granted, it's for freshmen, so he has no reason to be here. But luckily, there's a lot of people here today, so he won't be noticed. I sit in my usual spot in the middle of the classroom while Senpai sits right next to me. Then so do the tiger and leopard. Do they really need their own seats, though? Right now, the tiger looks calm and used to it. But the leopard is on edge. Ever since we got into the campus, he's been staring at almost everything. He didn't calm down after everyone took their seats either. How different is his hometown anyway? Although I'm curious, he hasn't spoken a word, so I ignore him for now and get ready for class. Class begins, I start making notes while Senpai keeps playing with his phone. All goes as expected. Surprisingly, the leopard looks over to see what I'm writing. It's a little weird being watched like this. However, him watching me while copying notes from the board is way better than when they were watching me browsing me online.
Hey, Aberrine, stop disturbing Lio.
Not disturbing.
Then keep some distance. You're distracting him from his studies, you know.
Well, I'm fine, actually. But is a little distracting to have a big cat's face right next to your notebook.
Huh.
The leopard moves his head away from my desk.
And you shouldn't just hang around here like a peasant. Do you know how annoying you are? If you want to stay, stay. But if you keep disturbing others, you're just pathetic.
Not disturbing. Han God ask for trouble.
I ask for trouble, you say? You're full of trouble yourself, breaking into other people's lives and not being aware of it. I don't mind if you insist on staying. But you can at least be considerate. Take a seat and keep yourself away from Lio as far as possible.
Hun God's words, not listening.
What? Are they seriously going to argue over this? I looked to Senpai, but he just took a glance over at the tiger and leopard, then went back to his phone.
Right. I am a Han god, and I am the protector of Lio. If you want Lio's help, you'd better listen to me. It's simply basic manners. Han god asked for trouble, not listening. Now I'm asking for trouble. If you...
Shut up! This is a classroom, you two! Oh... crap. I just realized that I shouted that aloud, in a classroom where no one else knows what the hell I'm going on about. Expectedly, everyone in the room stares at me.
Sir, what are you going on about?
No, it was, nothing. I'm sorry, I was just dreaming. I quietly try to muster my defense.
Don't doze off in my class! If you want to sleep, you shouldn't be in my class. This is your last chance, understood?
Yes, understood. Damn it, I'm completely lost with my notes now. Those two cats.
Lio, I'm sorry. I'm not used to the Aberine, and I forgot you could hear us. But like I said before, others won't hear us. There may be many situations like this from now on, so you should get accustomed to it.
Yeah, I realize that now. I just need some time to be accustomed to this, and you're in no place to criticize me. I feel ashamed and angry as I bury my face in my arms. I can't even listen to the class at this point. The two troublemakers remain silent from then onwards. It doesn't help much, as I could still feel the attention from everyone until class finished. I have to drag myself out of class. At least Senpai reassures me that with a pat on the shoulder.
You alright, Lyle? That really could have gone better.
Indeed, it really could have. What the hell was I thinking?
Sorry. Don't you even say that.
It's alright, you don't have to. I just remembered that I'm talking to nothing again. Thankfully, this time I'm walking in the corridor and it looks like I'm just talking to Senpai.
Lio, why do you keep covering up for this Aberine?
Could you stop calling him an Aberine? It's not really appropriate these days. I made sure to speak quietly, pretending that I'm talking to Senpai. Here's no need to play the race card now. Here's no need to play the race card now, and he didn't really disturb me to begin with, so don't just lay the blame on him.
Firstly, he called me a Han god. Secondly, Aberine is a proper noun. It's not like I've been calling him a barbarian.
It's not your words, it's your attitude.
So you mean I shouldn't hate him?
Yes?
I can't do that.
Alright, you're a guardian tiger from a high temple, but why be so strict? I mean, I'm a Han god as well, but Likulau doesn't bother me.
You are not nearly qualified to argue with me, you kitten.
Hey, don't call me a kitten!
I leave the two of them alone and walk to my next class. During the rest of the class, the arguing cools off, and at last I can have some peace. Senpai's full attention is now on his phone, but my notes are severely lacking. Recognizing some people from the last class who took notice of me leaves the atmosphere heavy and my unease lasts till class is over. Just as soon as I step outside, Senpai comes around in front of me and blocks my way dramatically.
Lio, let's go get dinner. We've already missed our chance at lunch.
Okay, what do you want?
Hot pot!
Senpai, aren't you forgetting that we still have club practice tonight?
Even when we have club practice, we still have time to eat, you know.
We're in the dance club, and it's not a great idea to dance on a full stomach. For starters, a hot pot is too filling, and secondly, we wouldn't have the time to eat one. Sorry, Senpai, there's no way I'm dancing after eating that much food.
Wah, it's such a great chance to dine with you, Lio.
It's alright, we'll have lots of chances. Why today?
I just thought, okay, you better keep your word.
It's really alright, I will. How about we just head off to the cafeteria now?
Yeah!
We move to the cafeteria and find a table for four. It's kind of a waste, even though technically there's four of us. After securing a table, Senpai and me went to the stalls. The leopard has never been to a cafeteria, so predictably he comes too. The tiger follows the leopard. He probably just wants to keep an eye on him. Our college does have a big cafeteria. Bentos, noodles, rice dishes, snacks, hamburgers, and there's a drink bar. You can almost grab whatever you want. Since we don't have much time, I only order chicken thigh rice. Senpai gets himself a pork rib noodle with a massive drink. Senpai, are you really going to drink that much before practice?
I thought we only had dance, recession today. Recession?
What? Recession? Recitation? What? Recession? I've never heard of that word before. What is that word? I'm not a big dance person, so I have no idea what that means. Dance? I thought he meant recital, but it's not recital. Recession? Okay. Right, we're not supposed to have a full car. We're not supposed to have full club practice today. There was only a recreation for the show yesterday. Recitation? It should be over in a couple minutes. But you never know, so I'm not about to stuff myself. When I try to argue further with Senpai, the tiger comes around.
Lio, what is that?
The hamburger? It's just a hamburger. You know, like meat, salad, and two buns. There should be a picture over there on the menu.
It seems there's a lot of different meals available, or meats available.
Oh, yeah, mostly pork or beef or chicken, though.
Wow, you didn't even know what a hamburger is? What rock did you live under?
My worshippers don't use this as a sacrifice.
Traditionally speaking, he's right to not have seen one.
So I guess you're with your family, that means you won't have had any... You won't have had any before coming here, too, then.
These days, I do love hamburgers, though. I even have egg hamburgers for breakfast all the time.
Egg burger? So that's the same thing.
Kinda. It's meat between two buns with a fried egg.
Quite different to the picture over there. What are you laughing at? So you've been well acquainted with all this for a long time, then, kitten?
A long time ago? You mean before I occupied its body? Well, I'm not sure. I have all his memories, after all, and I can't tell if those are his or mine, so maybe I didn't know before.
I see.
So why do you ask?
Nothing. Simple curiosity.
The old man definitely wants hamburger.
Really? So how about I get one for you?
No, it's fine.
But Lio, can you eat anymore?
Me? Nah, I'm not hungry.
So you're just going to throw all of that away? What a waste.
I thought the guardian tiger wanted to eat a burger, though. It's not like I need to eat anything.
Wow, Lio, and you call yourself a jitong? Guardian tiger here is a god. He doesn't literally eat things.
What? No, wait. So what do you mean by he doesn't eat things?
How should I explain? So when a god eats something, they just eat the chi within. They don't actually eat any of the food itself.
What is chi? I don't know. Oh. Oh no.
Basically, mortals won't see a difference.
So it's more like a sacrifice?
Yeah, so when you buy a hamburger for the old man over here, he can only enjoy the taste. So you have to finish it anyway, otherwise we'll just have thrown it away.
Okay, so the chi you mentioned, is that necessary for gods?
It's necessary, but gods won't run short on chi as long as people worship them. You're basically the priest for the old man, so he won't be hungry if you're here. I'm not that lucky since my furgong doesn't have worshippers these days. Although a god can maintain their power as long as a priest is present, it's better to have some sacrifices. Sacrifices are the best way to obtain chi and attain people's belief.
So I'm the priest?
You put my statue on your shelf, didn't you? You are also my worshipper, so your room could be considered my temple, and therefore you are my priest.
What a cruddy temple!
So I've served Guardian Tiger in this way? But by that logic, I've done embarrassing things in the temple. Is that even okay? That, and I've never worshipped Guardian Tiger statue properly, not to mention sacrifices. I don't really like the family traditions, but now I feel like I've treated the Guardian Tiger unfairly because I ignored them.
It's alright. I'm not really hungry. I just wanted to try.
It just makes things more difficult. I never offered a sacrifice to the Guardian Tiger, and now he asks for that. So I'll just go get one.
It's fine, Lio. There's no need to waste it.
That's right. You can get it tomorrow and eat it as dinner. And now that you can see this old man, you can just buy him whatever he wants. However, you know God will punish you if you waste food.
Yeah, okay.
I've pretty much decided now to buy the tiger whatever he wants. He is the guardian tiger of my family. It's the least I could do for him after ignoring him for so long. Now that I think about it, maybe the leopard wants something to eat as well? I look around and find him staring at a drink bar. Never mind, I go back to my dinner and finish my chicken thigh rice, return my tray, and head off to club with Senpai. Dance club is a space under the veranda for its activities. The wall is covered in mirrors, so we just call it the mirror wall. We find a corner to drop our things while the club mates stand around and talk to each other. The tiger leans against a pillar, watching us from the other side of the crowd, and the leopard is checking out the mirror wall, not sure if he's ever seen such a big mirror before. He must be shocked to be in our practice room after watching us last night. Usually, I would hang around with some other freshmen, but I just decided to keep an eye on Senpai. Granted, everyone looks so happy tonight after the great performance last night. Soon, the club leader arrives and gives us a rousing speech about the performance. Excitement is spread throughout the club, and I feel it too. I share this honor with my fellow club members. Our success and our failures are all felt as one. It's the arrangement our club shares together.
What a good club. I'll miss it.
Senpai, are you alright? You don't seem yourself. Have you got a cold?
No, why can't I be sentimental sometimes?
I didn't mean it like that, but what's wrong? Has anything happened to you?
I was talking as a guardian tiger. Because, you know, I have to leave school if you decide to go to Milo with me.
Well,
really, I have to leave anyway, even if you don't take my offer.
That's right, you have to go back anyway.
Yeah, though after being in this body for so long, I've started thinking being human isn't that bad. It's such a lovely club. It's pretty rare, right? After all, based on my memories, well, that's not a good topic.
What kind of topic?
It's nothing. So, talking about coming to Maloy, what do you think about it at the moment?
Oh god, what is this?
Well, you all want me to help, and it's hard for me to make a decision.
You can help all of us then.
No way.
Is it really impossible? I know it's not short work, but it's not like it would take you 5 years. Your guardian tiger wants you to go back home, but he didn't say when. I'm sure you could do that after helping me and the leopard, right?
How long would that take? 10 years? And I need to give up dancing during the best years of my career. There's no way.
So, then couldn't you just help me?
It's not that easy. You said it wouldn't take more than 3 years, so how many years exactly? And then, what should I do to rejuvenate your temple? I have no idea at this point.
That's a good point. I didn't really explain it to you before. Let me see. It's just a small temple, so it definitely won't take a lot of effort to run. More specifically, you've got to do the housekeeping, advertise for the temple, talk to people to see if we can help them, and so on.
Isn't that a lot?
Well, those are all pretty, all the petty things, but we have to build people's confidence in us step by step. It's never easy to convince people, so I can't tell you how long it's going to take.
Honestly, it sounds boring.
Maybe you can entertain yourself by dancing.
There's no way that will work, and you know that well, Senpai. I have no tutor or clubmates, so I wouldn't get anywhere.
That's true, but at least you have me. Just consider it.
But Senpai, I couldn't do all this while I'm at school, could I? Since I can't just drop out of school, will you wait until I graduate? And even then, if I choose to take 2 years off, I need to perform my military service before that. Wait, what? Military service? What the fuck's that? What? By law, you have to serve in the military? Is that a thing in Taiwan? I didn't know in Taiwan you had to, like, serve the military by law for, like, you have a duty to perform or serve in the military for a certain amount of years or something. And then 2 years with you? That's probably the end of my dancing career as it is. You could dance in the military. I mean, when was the last time Taiwan got in a war? World War II when they fought Japanese? I don't know. Like, Taiwan military probably isn't doing a lot of fighting. You could just dance the entire time. I'm sure it'll be fine.
I know, but seriously speaking, it's not easy to feed yourself by dancing anyway. Even Yan Shu-Chi, never thought about taking up dancing as a career. Are you going to insist on this?
But I can't just give up all the effort and lengths I've gone to so far.
It's called a hobby. We all have one, dude.
Well, honestly, you've only been dancing for half a year.
Bullshit. I've been working at this since high school. And my other options aren't much better. It's not like I like doing religious stuff.
I came to Taipei because I didn't want to be constrained by my family. And now you're asking me to just give up everything just because I have a special talent?
Yeah, I know. It's not something you could decide in a day, but I want you to consider it. I've just been driven up the wall. I am seeking your help because I really have no way out. So just consider it, all right?
I don't want to reject you, Senpai, but... Hey, Shu-Chi, come around. Someone is calling Senpai. It's our club leader.
Oh, right away!
Senpai sets off immediately. It seems that they're going to have a meeting. After all, Senpai is pretty important around here. He's the backbone of our club. But that means the end of our conversation, and I still have a lot to tell. When I get ready to move on, some of my buddies put me on the spot.
Yo, Lia, what's wrong with you and Shu-Chi, Senpai?
What's wrong with us?
You two seem pretty weird today. You came to practice together, then spend heaps of time talking to each other. So what? Are you dating him? What a bad boy.
What the hell? No, that's nonsense. We're not in that kind of relationship.
So what is going on between you two then?
We were just talking normally. Honestly, our conversation was serious, which I would say is pretty far from romantic.
Suspicious. I didn't see you two being that close before, and now it's like you two are inconspicuous. You see, people are staring at you.
Really? Looking around, a few guys from Shu-Chu Senpai Admirers Club staring at me. What the hell? We were just talking. Also, no. Literally no one is looking at you. They're all looking at other people or... Yeah, they're all looking at other people. Our club is a pretty chill atmosphere. Evidently, it leads to people talking about this stuff. And now I've got myself into this big misunderstanding. Are all the clubs like that, or just ours?
But I was just... So what are you doing before you arrived here together?
We had dinner?
Wow, you said you weren't in a relationship!
There is no relationship.
Just admit it, we're buddies, right? It's not that bad to be in love with Senpai. He's a great guy.
Like I said, we're not.
Even if you convince me, you can't convince the entire club. People want the truth. Alright. Lyle says there's nothing between them. Would you just leave him alone?
Another club mate pats the shoulder of the person talking to me.
Come on, you don't see risque things like this every day. You don't see a fight every day either, so shut up about it or I'll beat you.
Of course, he won't really beat up anybody, but those guys seem bored of teasing me anyway. Thank God. Thanks a lot, Jai-ho. One thing I know about Jai-ho, even though you can find 1,000 people on the street with his name, this guy is actually an Aboriginal, the Taiwanese, like the name suggests. Wait, what? Oh, this is a person we're talking to.
You're welcome. Sometimes you have to be tough with them.
It's hard to deny since Senpai has been living with me after being occupied by that leopard cat. I try to avoid Jio's eyes in embarrassment and notice the leopard hanging around.
Right, there's something I could ask Jai-ho.
Jai-ho, are you Rukai? The leopard reminds me that Jai-ho helped us a lot in our performance with information on the Rukai traditions. Maybe he knows something.
Yeah, what's up?
Which tribe?
Eh? What tribe?
It's... Well, where's your hometown?
Wutai, is that what you want?
Woo, what a coincidence!
Coincidence?
Nothing. I can't just tell him there's a clouded leopard from Wutai who wants my help, but I really want to ask him something about it. How should I begin? It's alright, just that, are you familiar with Rukai traditions?
Rukai traditions? I know a bit. How can I help you?
And do you know of any Rukai gods who were clouded leopards?
Well, I'm afraid it's not my specialty. Clouded leopards. Honestly, I have no idea.
None at all?
I don't know, or at least I can't tell you about any. Like I said, I don't know much about that stuff. But I have an aunt who teaches that stuff. I can ask her for help.
Really? Please ask her for me. I would owe you one.
You're welcome. Asking is no skin off my nose.
God, I hope not. That would be terrifying. Afterwards, Jio says goodbye to me and walks away. I look to find the leopard. Luckily, he's too busy watching the crowd to notice me asking about him. Or, for that matter, how embarrassed I was. It's strange, though. Jio says there's no clouded leopard gods in Rukai, but is that true? I mean, even with how reserved he is about it, he's usually on top of this stuff. I guess it could have just been him not remembering, like he said. I'm starting to wonder if I should talk to the leopard about this, but I'm interrupted by a senpai coming back. Okay, whew. With that out of the way, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst Nekojishi player you've ever seen before. Whew. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye!